Good morning, students. Today we start the second part of the chapter Agriculture in India, Food Crop, that is it, pulses and the mills. First of all, we talk about the pulses, which in Hindi we call dals. What are pulses? They are the edible seeds like peas, beans, lentils, and similar plants having pods. That is called a pulses, like moong dal, masoor dal, chana dal. Okay, these are from under the pulses. Pulses also are food grains. They are called dals, and they are very important in the Indian diet. Gram, urad, moong, masoor, arhar. These are the principal pulses. Pulses have a very nutritious value and provide us much needed protein for the vegetarian people. Pulses play a great role in the vegetarian diet, meaning those are vegetarian, they take protein that from the protein the pulses is there. Pulses not provide for the needs of the human being, but also provide for the foodstuff for the animals. Pulses play as a means grown as a rotational crop because they are leguminous plants with a root nodules which fix and utilize that the atmospheric nitrogen in the soil. They are rotated with other crops to maintain heavy so that the fertility is there. Now we talk about that the grain. Gram is like black chana or white chana. It accounts for nearly 37% of total production of pulses in India. And for the climatic conditions, gram can be grown in that mild, cool, dry climate with temperature 20 to 45 degrees Celsius. It is a dry crop and it is grown in the rabi season. Just like that, the temperature means rainfall, like a wheat, it requires 50 to 100 cm moderate rainfall. So, what is the methods of cultivation? It is sown between September and November and harvested in February and the April this year. It is rotated as pure mixed crop with wheat, barley, and mustard. It is mostly sown in rows. And so it means that the severe cold and excessive rain both are harmful for this crop. Now we'll talk about the uses. Gram is used as dal, besan, roasted, cooked, and for various preparations that include sweets and cereals. You can say what are the halwa you people eat, besan halwa you eat. Okay, its green leaves are used as a vegetables or that is also provided as a for the cattle or horses also stated. Now, which are the areas of where the gram is grown and found in maximum? That is UP, Himachal Pradesh, Rajasthan, and the Haryana. Now, we talk about that the next crop, that is the millets. Millets apply to various minor grains which are mainly grown in areas where rice, wheat cannot be grown. Millets serve as a food grain for the poor section of the society and for the underdeveloped country people is there. And it provides that the, it is used for that the, means the fodder for that the cattle in that the, means you can say the 12 countries. Because this millets are provided to given to the cattle or the animals to fatten them to get maximum the flesh from them. They are also called hardy plants because they are resistant to heat and drought during the growing season. They can also be cultivated dry apart. Millet is common name for the several species of grass-like plants. The important millets are cultivated in India: jowar, bajra, and ragi. So what kind of condition is required for that the millet journal? Millet require temperature ranging from 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. It cannot be grown when the temperature is below 60 degrees Celsius. Rainfall, because I told you, millets are the diet crop. So it can be grown in arid or semi-arid region, having rain for 50 to 120 centimeter, less than 100 centimeter rainfall, they can also grow. They not need too much rainfall here. Soil, millets can be grown from variety of soil. They do not have any special requirement for weather. Soil, they are cultivated on heavy, light, alluvial to red soil also. It can also grow in the sandy soil also. Now we talk about weather. What is jor? Jor is a... That is a grown in both kharif or rabi season. After wheat and rice, jor is the most popular food crop. And what kind of climatic condition required for jor is there? Generally, we already discussed in the millet part. Temperature 26 to 33 degrees Celsius. You can say 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. That is the average ranging of temperature required for all kind of millet. And amount of rainfall 50 to 100 centimeter, 50 to 120 centimeter. That is the average amount of rainfall is needed for all kind of jor. That means that millet is there. It cannot grow where the rainfall is more than 100 centimeter. Jor is a rain-fed crop and dry farming area where the irrigation is not needed. Excessive rain or drought conditions both are harmful for this plant here. Jor is used as a making of roti. When we have to prepare the flour from the jor seeds, then there is a black color that flour is formed there, and just like a cement like that, the chapati is made. Mostly these chapatis is given to those people who do hard work is there. And the areas of the jor cultivation area, the Maharashtra is the leading producer of jor here. Then Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Rajasthan area. In these part areas that is grown here. Next is the bajra. We can also say bulrush. Also, that is also a kharif crop. Bajra is a kharif crop. That is used as a food crop as well as a fodder crop. Now, we talk about that. For what means the bajra is grown as a rotation crop, it is related mostly cotton or jowar or ragi. What kind of weather? Climatic condition required for weather? Jowar. Soil. It can be grown in a variety of soil from poor light, sandy soil or black, red or alluvial also. You can say that in that kind of soil it can be grown. What is the temperature condition? Here you can see the temperature condition is given 25 to 35 degrees. But already I told you 27 to 32 degrees Celsius or 27 to 33 degrees Celsius. That is considered as a average temperature for all kind of millet. That is suitable for that. Rainfall improve well where rainfall is less than 100 cm. 50 to 100 cm already we discussed in the previous crop also. It is also rain-fed crop and seldom irrigated. Rain-fed crop means if rain means how much water is required, what is getting from the rain that is sufficient for the crop is there. Now areas of the till that this crop is grown, this crop is excessively grown in Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat, UP, Bihar, Rajasthan. Rajasthan is considered for the larger producer of the bajra and jowar. Maharashtra we already discussed. Next is the ragi, that is called a bakla. Ragi is a kharif crop and ragi is the another millet mainly grown in the drier part of the south. Previous one crop is grown in the south, that is a jowar, and second one is the ragi is there. But this crop ragi grown in the south also, north also. It is a means what kind of soil is required for this? Red, ripe, black, sandy soil, that is good for that. Means all kind of layers, we can say that the sandy soil is suitable for all kind of crops is there. Means any kind of soil is good for the millet is there. They can grow in any kind of soil. temperature here given 20 to 30 degrees Celsius, average 27 to 32 degrees Celsius is considered. Rainfall 50 to 100 centimeter. Same way, like Pajar, there also rainfall crop is there. And the areas that is mostly known on the Deccan Plateau, Karnataka is the larger producer of the bracken. In each crop which you already discussed, you have to learn about that the largest producer of the particular crop and another two name of that the particular crop is there. In this video, I have to given you that the reduced syllabus, whatever the PDF is going to send you in the form of question answers, you have to write the answers only the related questions, not anything else. Thank you.